Welcome into the Cowboys Report. It is Cowboys Eagles post-game reaction, some news, some highlights conversation, as well as Dallas, admittedly, against a mostly Eagles backup team, blew them out of the water. 51-26, the final in this game. Dallas moves to 6-0, a clean sweep of the NFC East this year. They average score like 40-18. Team 40 Burger lived and rode against the NFC East this year. Dak Prescott, a record-setting day. 5 touchdowns, his career high. Breaks the single-season Cowboys touchdown passing mark previously set by Tony Romo. The offense, the Cowboys, big deal about it. Got to get rhythm. Got to get right. Got to get some mojo, some flow going. Entering the postseason, they did that. 51 points. And they did it through the air early on. Dak Prescott was dealing. He and Cedrick Wilson had himself a ball game in this one. The mostly first half offense was incredible for the Dallas Cowboys. Again, I know it's against backups. I acknowledge that off the top. Still, what more are you asking for out of the Cowboys in this particular offensive showing? Frankly, not much more you could want. Defensively, some issues there. Now, again, against mostly backups, so the Eagles receivers played most of that game outside of Devonta Smith, who got benched when he set his own mark, his own record. Jayron Kearse, no Trayvon Diggs, no Micah Parsons, no Anthony Brown. You missed those 4 starters for you. The first half defense was not very good in this game. Then they kind of tightened it up a little bit as the game went on around the time Devonta Smith left that game. Third down pickups, a lot of third and shorts, an issue. So not perfect from Dallas. But still, if I had told you, hey, the Cowboys beat the Eagles 51-26, you would have said, awesome. I love that for the Cowboys. So I want you guys to grade the Cowboys' performance tonight in prime time on Saturday Night Football. A, B, C, D, or F. How you feeling about the Cowboys in this particular game? Now, this question, we'll get to the kicker here first and foremost. The kicker, who, again, for the record, I will not be calling by his proper name until he earns it, damn it. The kicker is not doing well. He is a problem for you. The kicker has very real issues at the moment. He's got to figure it out. So we're actually make this one the pinned comment on today's video. What to do with the kicker? I almost did it. I almost said his name. K for keep. I went full Ron Burgundy. K for keep. C for cut. What do you guys want to do with the kicker? This is the pinned comment. So if the ad break comes on YouTube, head down there and let me know what you think about the kicker. He's a problem, guys. He is going to screw you. He, frankly, can be attributed to at least potentially missing out on the number 2 seed. You change a game against the Bucks, against the Cardinals, against the Raiders, you might have that number 2 seed. You might still be alive for the number 1 seed, even. He's cost you games this year, as have, to be fair, plenty of players and coaches. But when the kicker can't do his job, when he's missed 12 kicks, he's a problem. Step number 1 begins tomorrow. If you are the Dallas Cowboys and you are serious about winning a title, you have to at least work out kickers. If they don't do well, okay, I get it. That's fair. I understand. At least you tried. Assuming it's going to be fixed when it hasn't worked this year is the literal definition of insanity. So try it out. Bring in Kai Forbath and others for a workout, because the kicker is a real issue right now for the Cowboys. If you bet on the over or Dallas to cover, congrats. The Cowboys took care of it with no issues in this one. The over was, I think, 45.5. The Cowboys themselves covered it. 125% deposit bonus on BetUS when you use promo code Cowboys125 at chatsports.com/bet. Again, promo code Cowboys125 at chatsports.com/bet. Maybe you want to parlay the Cowboys, boost their seed hopes. Now, I'm not buying the Bucks beating the Panthers, but If the Niners, who appear set to start Jimmy G, beat the Rams, a 3.5-point underdog the Niners are, and the Seahawks, a 6-point underdog against the Cardinals, if they can upset both of those teams, Seattle over Arizona, the Niners over L.A., that gets the Cowboys to the number 3 seed. So with that in mind, what seed will the Dallas Cowboys get in the postseason this year? If one of those teams lose, it's not going to happen. The Cowboys will then either get the Rams or the Cardinals, depending on who wins the division. What seed will they get? 2, 3, or 4 are your options. There's no number 1 seed to be had at this point. Let's move on to the injury update here on one Neville Gallimore. He left the game late in that game. Now, we don't know what exactly it was. He was in good spirits on the sidelines afterwards, so I think he's going to be okay. We'll see on Neville Gallimore. The real concern right now, if it is a concern, is over Keanu Neal. He left the game with an arm and shoulder. That was actually just mentioned by the Cowboys' PR team. He will be evaluated Sunday back in Dallas. So I think Neville Gallimore is going to be okay. Keanu Neal, I'm not so sure about. We'll see moving forward. The other update on Jayron Kearse. He is the latest Cowboys player to catch COVID-19 for Dallas. Unfortunately, he had already been ruled out of the game with a hamstring injury. In theory, he should be back in time for the playoff game. Now, I'm not too concerned about that. You got the 5-day window to be cleared. You got plenty of time from that standpoint. But as injuries and hopefully not COVID news end up hitting the Cowboys, we will break it down for you right here on the Cowboys Report. It will be a clinching scenario as the Cowboys wait and hope to pray no COVID news hitting them as they get closer, not knowing when they will play their playoff game until later Sunday night. Let's talk Dak Prescott. Again, backups, I know. What a showing. 21 of 27. 295 and 5 touchdowns. There is not much more you could ask for out of Dak Prescott. The Cowboys made a big deal. Hey, we want to be in rhythm. We want to get the offense going. We want to have some momentum and some confidence. Dak Prescott said after the game, real shit starts now. He's right. So is Dak back? Why for yes and for no? He has not played bad, really, at any point this year. A couple bad throws, make no mistakes about it, but he wasn't playing the way he was at the beginning of the year. Now, he might be. To be fair, this was against backups. This is not Darius Slay and Derek Barnett and Josh Sweat and Brandon Graham and Fletcher Cox. It's not who they were playing against. It was against backups, to be fair. But that was pretty much a perfect first half and borderline game out of Dak Prescott. His receivers made some nice plays. That always helps you out as well. Now, Dak's got to go do it. The Cowboys, I should say, have to go do it in the playoffs. But you should be feeling good about the offense after drop 50 against backups or not. That's not easy to do in the NFL. How about the play now of Cedrick Wilson? Woohoo, boy. 5 catches, 119 yards, and 2 scores in this one. Cedrick Wilson back in the starting lineup, he balled out. The Cowboys, I believe, are... No, they're not. Never mind. Take that back. Cedrick Wilson, it was awesome, man. So both Cedrick Wilson and Michael Gallup are going to be free agents this offseason. We will have this conversation many a time. Pick one to keep after the brief moment where Malik Turner was the flavor of the month. It's one of these two guys. CW for Cedrick Wilson, MG for Michael Gallup. Let's talk DeMarcus Lawrence. The run defense earlier was not granting. The CDs made some mistakes, but Tank Lawrence and a limited snap count, a key pass break and a sack. Those two plays, by the way, back-to-back. Killed a drive where the Eagles were still kind of, sort of, hanging around in this one. Lawrence had himself a nice day as Randy Gregory was a bit banged up in this one. Nahshon Wright got his first start, left the game, then came back, looked okay, good news there. Got picked on a little bit early, and then the Eagles kind of weren't as efficient through the air, so he was okay. I thought he was fine watching live. Got beat a few times for his first ever start. Some good stuff to build on. Kelvin Joseph, I thought he was solid. He should have an INT. That early drive off his hands into the waiting arms of Devonta Smith. He's a good tackler. Smith beat him pretty good in this particular ball game before Smith left the game, and then Joseph played much better after that point. His numbers won't look great. I think he's going to get dinged for the late touchdown because he got blocked. It was his man, and as Trevon Diggs happened many times to him, or Trevon Diggs, no one made the tackle. So it kind of screwed Joseph. Overall, honestly, thought he kind of played like Anthony Brown has this year. Beat a few times, made some nice plays. Overall, pretty solid showing. But I think he's going to start next week with Anthony Brown at nickel because I don't think Jordan Lewis is going to be a starter anymore. We'll see. Luke Gifford made some nice plays as well. Couple nice tackles in this ball game. Leighton Vander Esch rallied late. Rough showing early on with Keanu Neal. Maybe banged up. It's good news for Luke Gifford. Who should get the ball? The game ball. Said that wrong. The game ball for Dallas. I think it's pretty clear. Got to be Dak Prescott, right? You throw five touchdowns, ball out until you get sacked because the game's over. I think it's Dak, but I want to hear from you guys. Let me know in the comments. Some more offensive thoughts here. Ezekiel Elliott did get to 1,000 yards on the season. Overall, despite not looking that explosive, one of his more efficient games of the year. It's a better sign for the Cowboys. Good things happen when Amari Cooper is involved with this offense. 5 catches, 79 yards. What had a touchdown, by the way, had he not jumped. They ran a play to Cooper. He jumped and carried himself out of bounds. If he just kept his feet in, wasn't a high throw, would have been 6. Blake Jarwin, welcome back to Jarwin. 1 catch, 6 yards, almost had himself a touchdown as well. Tough play to make off his fingertips, a very tight window throw. Couldn't bring it in, but it's nice to have Jarwin back for that 21 personnel. And Dalton Schultz, he and Cedrick Wilson are going to make bank this offseason. Schultz, 3 catches, 21 yards, 2 scores. Pretty damned efficient there for the Dallas Cowboys as Schultz has a good showing in this one. The playoff picture briefly here as Dallas goes 6-0 against the NFC East this season. They are 12-5. They need a Rams loss and a Cardinals loss to jump to the number 3 seed. They also need a Bucks loss, in addition to those two, to jump to the number 2 seed. Will that happen? We'll find out on Sunday.